The Wastegate is a fairly well-developed product by this point in time, but Turbosmart have been continuing to refine and develop Wastegate technology. In particular, one of the products that they have released at the SEMA 2022 show is a pneumatic version of their straightgate. We're here with Stewart from Turbosmart to find out a little bit more about this product. So before we get into the specifics of this pneumatic version, Stewart, what is a straightgate and how does it differ from a conventional poppet-style wastegate?
So a straight gate is in essence a butterfly style external wastegate. So it's a balanced poppet. It's a balanced valve, and we can get for the same size, we can get more flow, and we can get a larger range in boost pressures. With a poppet valve, you've got all the force acting in one direction, trying to open a valve if you're trying to keep the valve closed to make more boost. But on a butterfly, because it's balanced, we don't have the same forces, so we've got a slightly different way of controlling our boost.
Okay, we'll come back to those forces and why it allows a wider range of boost in a moment. But first of all, you said that straight gate style offers increased flow. So can you give us some numbers, like how does that relate? What have you got there from the 50 mil straight gate? How does that relate to your existing poppet style range?
So our 50 mil straight gate at the moment flows more than our 60 mil. So it's the highest flowing wastegate that we have, but it's obviously in a smaller valve size. So you can see with the butterfly, we're not having to turn the air 90 degrees. It's just a straight shot through the product. So we're not getting as much heat into the product either. We can get rid of that, and we can use that to make the system more efficient.
In terms of packaging, from a fabrication standpoint, physically getting one onto an exhaust manifold compared to an existing poppet style, as you mentioned, the poppet style sort of turns the air through 90 degrees. Are there any complexities or problems in the packaging or any advantages with the straight gate style?
So the disadvantages, if anything, would be that you might have to turn the exit of the manifold a little bit further, another 90 degrees. But you should be able to get a straighter shot from where you are to where you want to go. Sometimes with a poppet style, you're turning 90 degrees again, and then going where you want to. So this way we can get a smoother flow into the wastegate, and we're a little bit more efficient on the way out. And also, due to the fact that it is a straight piece, you can rotate that wastegate anywhere 360 degrees to get the actuator out of the way.
Okay, in terms of the flow through it, obviously we mentioned there it's the highest flowing product you've got. The other aspect though, in terms of boost control, the linearity of the flow through it, or how that's integrated with the control system. And I mean, if we compare, it's essentially a throttle body, and if we look at the flow through a throttle body, it's very non-linear, almost exponential, in terms of we get quite a large increase initially for a small opening, and the further we open it, the less additional flow we get. I don't actually know how that relates to a poppet style, but are there any pros and cons there with the linearity of flow between the two?
So one of the things that you can get with a poppet wastegate is that the initial lift can create a fair bit of flow. So you can initially have a little bit of trouble controlling the pressure. With the butterfly or the throttle body style, it's a little bit slower, can be a little bit slower off the seat. So you may have to move it a little bit faster than you're used to get your initial boost control. What we have done with the pneumatic one though is we have modified the linkages to make it replicate the way a poppet valve works, so that you're not having to change your boost control strategies too much.
So essentially with those linkages, what you're meaning is the movement of the actuator versus the opening of the butterfly is no longer linear. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. We're just trying to get it to move a little bit faster initially than what it would be, depending on exactly how we line that actuator up with the butterfly mechanism.
Now, anyone who has spent any time looking at throttle bodies, maybe fitting an aftermarket throttle body, would know that generally in the closed position, they still maybe allow a little bit of airflow, not an issue with a throttle body, but obviously we do not want any leaking through that wastegate when it should be closed. So is there anything special you're doing to make sure that is sealed absolutely tight and leakage is absolutely not an issue when it's closed?
Yeah, so if you have a look at the design of it, we're using we're not sealing on the diameter of the ID of the pipe. We've got a hard valve seat there, And that allows us to really keep this thing clamped and closed. There is a tiny little bit of leakage around the shaft, but we have we've looked at that, and the percentage is it's 0.006 of what a wastegate might need to get up on, a turbocharger might need to get up onto boost. It's very insignificant, and we think we've found the way of making sure that the thing can handle the heat. It's reliable at high temperature. And we can get a good seal.
Okay, so very different to how a conventional throttle body seals, as you mentioned there, on the outside diameter. So thanks for clearing that up. Now, what was the impetus behind adding the pneumatic version? As I've mentioned, this isn't specifically a new product. It's a new product with a pneumatic actuator. Previously, you only had the electronic version. So, yeah, what was the, was there a demand there for a pneumatic version of this?
It was really, the demand was from us. We wanted to use it ourselves, and we could understand that there's advantages in electronic, and there's also advantages between a poppet and the butterfly or the straightgate style. So we can blend those two things together now, and you can just pick and choose. If high-end programming isn't your thing, then you can use the pneumatic version. You can probably adapt your existing knowledge to the new system without, you know, without going too far.
So you're not really saying this product is here to replace all existing conventional poppet style wastegates. It's just an alternative option.
It's an alternative. It's a pretty good alternative option. So we'll see what happens. But yeah, you can. We're having options for different people.
All right, let's talk about one of the other advantages which you alluded to, which is the wider range of boost control. So one of the downsides, which is very easy to overlook with a conventional poppet style wastegate, is that yes, we have boost pressure that we can act on one side of the diaphragm, but what people really easily overlook is we have exhaust manifold back pressure, which can be really significant, acting on the poppet valve itself. And at some point when that back pressure gets too high, it physically just starts pushing the valve open. Now, you mentioned this one is balanced, the straight gate's balanced, so we don't really have that issue with the EMAP trying to force the gate open. So what's that actually give in terms of control range of the boost? What have you seen so far?
So far, we are using a 5-pound spring, and we are up to 35 pounds boost on our test engine. We can't go any further because we won't have an engine left. But yeah, 5-pound spring, we're using a traditional 3-port solenoid control method. So we're only using or bleeding off the top port of the actuator, and we're at 45% duty cycle. So 5-pound spring, 35 pounds of boost on the engine, 45% duty cycle. Theoretically, I don't know, you have a guess, where do you think we can get to?
it's always hard to sort of give specific numbers, yeah. But I mean, for a conventional engine with quite high exhaust back pressure, that 5 PSI spring, we might be able to get the engine up to maybe the high teens, maybe the low 20s. I mean, there's no blanket rule there.
But that spike, and then it's going to come back down again. You're not going to be able to keep it.
Yeah. So that's the sort of range we might get. Then people go to a 4-port solenoid to get more range, but those have their own issues in terms of losing resolution. So, you know, the fact that you're getting to 35 PSI from a 5 PSI starting point at only 45% duty cycle, yeah, I mean, it does sound like there's a lot more range left in that, which is pretty special. So spring changes, a thing of the past maybe?
Potentially, yeah. We will be selling it. We will be selling it with different springs, and obviously some people might want to start with a higher base pressure if that's what they're used to, so we're going to still have that option. But at the moment, we're not really sure where the limit is. Yeah. We could be 10 times spring pressure, but we haven't got there yet.
In terms of other features with this, you've got two different styles of pneumatic actuator for this. One includes vacuum. Can you talk us through the differences between these and why you would choose one or the other?
Yeah, so you've got your normal pressure actuator. We all know how they work with a traditional boost controller, but we also have a vacuum version. So we're using vacuum to close the wastegate. So the wastegate is normally open if the engine's turned off. And one of the reasons why some of the OEs use that system is because it's that they can isolate the wastegate from whatever the engine's doing. So there's a vacuum pump on board. They can open and close the wastegate regardless. what's going on in the engine. And one of the things they do with that is they'll open the wastegate at startup, and it actually allows them to light the catalytic converter faster for emissions. So it's just giving, once again, it's another different lot of options for our customers. If people are making kits and they want to get that thing through and passed, it's just another tool that they can use to help them out.
I mean, particularly as emissions compliance is becoming more and more stringent, anything you can do to get that catalytic converter up to temperature and working faster is obviously going to be beneficial. Look, great to get some insight into those products, Stewart. And if people do want to learn a little bit more about them, where are they best to go to?
Yeah, just turbosmart.com. We've got all the new products available on our site, and come and have a look.
Perfect. Thanks for your time.
Cheers. Thanks.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.